You know what was the problem with the black body radiations? What was the problem with this one? Its plot, which was like you are heating a body, and radiations are emitted from this body, and if you plot the wavelength on this side, and you see the intensity or the number on this side, which was a specific number I am not mentioning, but it was like this. Means some lower wavelengths were less in number, some wavelengths were very high in number, and then it was the number of wavelengths, means the higher energy it was decreasing. So it was such type of distribution of waves. At this point, some people like Rayleigh jeans, Wayne's law and all those, they actually explained half portion of this one, not in full. There was not a single equation in which you put the values and it gives you plot like this. Some were fitting this portion and some were fitting this portion. So this was a problem, and this problem was addressed by Max Planck, right? This problem was addressed by Max Planck. This problem was addressed by Max Planck, and it was very first thing that he said, and what he said actually was that energy is in different modes, and those modes are actually, each mode is given by h nu by e power h nu over kBT, kB the Boltzmann constant, minus 1. I will not discuss the black body radiation in detail, but we'll just take out what I want from this one. Means the very first time he introduced this thing, h, the Planck constant, and he said that energy is not something continuous, but it is actually discrete in nature, and the energy can be written as E equals h nu. Nu being the frequency, h the Planck constant. So these were called discrete packets of energy. And those packets were actually named as quanta. The singular law, this is one packet is called quantum, while many packets will be quantum. So the quantum mechanics actually started from here. So from quantum, it's quantum. And you know about this tussle, that whether light is a wave or it's a particle. It wasn't, you can say, from this point, but you know the way far history, means Isaac Newton, he was of the opinion that light is not a wave, it is particle in nature, and he called those particles as corpuscles. It was corpuscular theory. So those were, he called them corpuscles, he called them quanta. So it is the same thing. While his opponent was Huygens,
Okay, his opponent was hyphen. I hope the spelling is right. Okay, I think it is U here or okay, hyphen. Hyphen was of the concept that light is a wave. Hyphen. So he was, Hyphen was of a concept that it is actually a wave, particle, corpuscles, and then quanta. So it's the same approach, but different names were given. And Max Planck actually fitted this spectrum very well. And he explained the black body radiation. And then another problem came in after the black body radiation with the photoelectric effect. You know about the photoelectric effect. People were not able to explain the photoelectric effect with the help of wave theory. It wasn't, they were not able to explain by considering light as a wave. So, what Einstein actually did, you know that there were some basic concepts regarding photoelectric effect. That if you take a metal surface, and you shine ultraviolet rays on this one, then those ultraviolet rays actually eject out electrons from this surface. But there was some problem that electrons were being ejected out by a certain frequency only, not lower than that frequency, and this frequency was called a threshold frequency. So not all frequencies were able. When the frequency reaches this value, then electrons are ejected out, otherwise not. The other problem was the intensity. If you increase the intensity of the light, then electrons and the frequency is below the threshold frequency, then electrons were not emitted. This was a problem. Why not intensity is emitting those electrons? When you match the threshold frequency, means your energy comes exactly equal to the threshold energy or the threshold frequency, then the electrons are ejecting out from the metal surface. And then when you increase the intensity, the number of electrons are increased. But if you are below a threshold frequency, then electrons are not ejected from the metal surface. So what's the problem then? And this issue was solved by Albert Einstein, and for this he got Nobel Prize. He got Nobel Prize for this. So, but the same concept that light is a particle, and Einstein called his particle is photon. So it is the same corpuscle, it is the same quantum which he called is photon. And he established one principle which explained the whole photoelectric effect. He said that one photon will interact with one electron only, right? With one electron only. Like for example, the binding energy, which you call the work function, this work function is equal to h nu naught. This is the work function, or this is the binding energy of the electron to its surface. You know, electrons are plenty on a metal surface, but inside a metal they are having some work function. When, let's say, this work function is equal to 3 electron volt, for example, when the energy of a single photons become 3 electron volt or greater than this one, principally it should be slightly greater than this one. We say greater or equal, but principally this one should be slightly greater than this one in order to conserve the momentum law, the law of conservation of momentum. So if the electron, if the photon energy is equal to this one or greater than this one, then it will eject out the electron, right? But what about 2 photons? If 2 photons are there and each photon is having 1.5 electron volt energy, then the sum of them is 3 electron volt. Whether those 2 photons will come in, they will be able to eject the electron? The answer was no, because the number of photons is called intensity, right? You are having 1 electron, 2, 3, 4, what you are doing? You are increasing the intensity of the electrons. Their energy is the same, like it will be 1.5. So even if 100 electrons comes in with 1.5 electron volt, they will not be able to eject out the electron from it. But a single proton with this much energy can eject it out. That's the difference. That was the establishment of this principle by Albert Einstein, that one photon will interact with one electron. Right? So the individual energy of the photon should be this, which is called the threshold energy or the threshold frequency. So that's why you are increasing the intensity, electrons will not be ejected. But once you reach the threshold energy, the threshold frequency, each electron coming with a threshold, with energy greater than the threshold energy, then you increase the number of electrons, the number of ejected electrons will be increasing. Then it will contribute to the intensity of the electrons, right? So this was a principle which Einstein established, and he resolved the issue of photoelectric effect. And then there was another thing, when an electron comes in, when a photon comes in and it hits this electron, but it doesn't eject it out of the metal surface, but it only displaces it and then go here with some angle. And this thing was addressed in Compton. This was addressed in Compton. When it is ejected out, photoelectric effect. When it is not ejected out, but the photons give some energy to it, and with the rest of energy the photon will go that way, and it was discussed in the Compton effect, right? And the very first time that we know, for a classical body the momentum is mv. Now what will be the momentum for a wave? The momentum for a wave is h bar k. This is not h cut, this is h bar. H bar is called the reduced Planck constant, and it is equal to h over 2 pi. What is 2 pi? 2 pi is the complete circular angle. So it is actually making it in accordance to the circular geometry and linear geometry. This is linear, this is circular, h bar. So this is the reduced Planck constant. Momentum will be equal to this thing. Clear? And then another very big question came in, and that very big question which changed almost the shape of physics, and it was the thinking that In 1924, Louis D. Broglie, there was a question, and the big question was that it is okay that the thing that we knew, which are waves, they started behaving like matter, like light was a corpuscle or quanta or photons. Waves behaved like matter, no problem with this one, it was resolved. But whether this thing is true as well, that the matter will behave like wave, this was a big question. Is it possible for the matter to behave like wave? And this was the thesis of Louis D. Broglie. You know, it was the shortest thesis, and you know about the, it was a hypothesis. You know De Broglie hypothesis. It was a hypothesis. What is hypothesis? It's like my thinking, what I think. And this was also very dramatic at that time, that there was a person who was very arrogant, and his name was Peter Debye. So Debye was an arrogant person, and he was the head of the department where De Broglie was actually working. Where he was a student, and he actually said that now he will be giving doctorate degrees on hypotheses, it's a joke. And he actually rejected his work, that this is a childish theory, that it's a childlike thinking, that matter will behave like a wave. And he actually, Peter Debye, invited this person